nice. And itching and itching and itching, then finally blister comes out. When the blister is coming out, that time it is giving so much pain. Then pus is forming. So after that, one is going to hospital and getting medical treatment for that. So this itching is, from the beginning, it looks like that very nice, very pleasurable one. But finally, later on, one is suffering like anything. So therefore, those who are illusioned, those who are bewildered, they do not know where the pleasure is, how one can get pleasure. So, and also, the moment one is coming to this material world, coming in contact with this material world, then he is becoming contaminated. So he is not able to find the way how one can go to get the real happinesses. So therefore one is suffering here. Kende bale ohe Krishna amito bodas, tomar charan chadi hoilo sarvanas. When you'll cry and say, O Krishna, O the Supreme Lord, I have given up your lotus feet, therefore I am suffering. Therefore my life became miserable. And when he will again come back to the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord Krishna, then his life will be again pleasurable, very blissful one. And why one is not coming to Krishna? Because he is in Maya, he is in illusion. He is thinking that where he is, he can make that place very pleasurable, blissful. So, in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna said to Arjuna, Daivi hesa gunamayi mama maya durataya mama vaje prapadyante maya metang tarantite. Who can come out from the clutches of maya? Who is surrendering unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord? He can come out from the maya. Because the maya cannot remain, the illusion cannot remain where the absolute truth is present. Therefore, in our Back to Godhead, we say the Krishna Surya Sama Maya Hoy Andhakar Jaha Krishna Tanai Maya Radhikar. So Krishna is just like effulgent sun. If someone is accepting Krishna, serving Krishna, remaining with Krishna, then how Maya can come? Maya is darkness. The darkness cannot remain where there is sunlight. So Krishna is just like effulgent sun. So Maya is darkness. So Maya cannot come to Krishna. So therefore Krishna said, if you are surrendering unto his lotus feet, then they can overcome this Maya. Duratikrama Maya. Very difficult to overcome by our own way, we cannot overcome Maya. So it is also said, Maya ke koriya joy chharana na jai. You cannot conquer Maya. You cannot defeat Maya. And if you say that by our own way, we will become free from this illusion, it is not possible. You cannot do it. Because Maya is Krishna's energy, Krishna's potency, lower potency, but Krishna's lower potency. Krishna means the Supreme Lord, Supreme Lord's potency. And we are tiny one, how can we overcome Maya? So if someone is intelligent enough, then he will try to come to Krishna. He will try to come to the Supreme Lord. So by the mercy of Supreme Lord, one can give up Maya, or one can say, if we are inside here, we are protected. The moment we'll go outside gate, we cannot say what will happen. Maya is very strong. So therefore, we can take example. a rich man. He's having so much wealth, money. And he is spending his life very luxurious way. Sleeping in very nice bed, going by a nice car. Everything is going very nice. But when his life air is going out, so what is happening? The car is there, the building is there, money is there in bank, everything is there. But he is not able to enjoy it because something has gone from his body. The body is there also. The same skin is there, but cannot get pleasure by touching. Same eyes are there, but by seeing he is not getting any pleasure. Same ears are there, but he is not getting any pleasure listening anything. So everything is intact, but he is not able to enjoy it anymore. But all the way, he was trying, he was making so much endeavor to get so much money to come to that situation. But he is not able to relish it now. So what is that? Why one is not relishing this? Because something was inside that has gone out. Inside the body something was there and it has gone out, therefore one is not able to get pleasure, cannot enjoy anymore, just lying. And you burn body or bury? Both. Who is burning and who is burying? So what is happening? What is happening to this body? Bhasma krumi bishta hobe sakalero ghurnyatobe ihate ma mata arvachina. So much affection, so much love, so much attachment to this body. But finally this body is becoming just, if you will burn it, it will become ashes. If you will bury it, then the worms will be there. And nobody will like that. Can you embrace that body which worms are eating? You cannot. Bhasma krumi vishtahabe sakaler ghurnyatabe. So all are disliking that body now. Yate mamata arvachina, but we are having so much affection, so much love, so much attachment to this body. So those who are really intelligent person, they will think other way. Those who are actually little bit illusion has gone, they will think other way. So they will try to think about who is inside body, who has gone out now, for which the body is not unwanted body now. So he will think about that is soul, atma. So how the atma will be happy? We all the way we are thinking how body will be happy. How my body will be happy? There is sthula linga deha. Sthula deha, gross body. Linga deha is subtle body, mind, false ego, intelligence. So we are always thinking how to give pleasure to our gross body and subtle body. But no more, we cannot give any more pleasure to them. Because the atma has gone out. So why not we'll think about this atma, this soul? Then when we'll think about atma, this soul, then we'll think what is the need of soul. When we are thinking about the body, body needs to drink, eat, sleep, eating, sleeping, mating, defending. These are the need of body. Body needs to sleep, body needs to eat. But Atma does not need to sleep, eat, mate, or defend. Atma's need is how to go to the super soul, Paramatma. How to be connected with the Supreme Atma. Supreme Atma is Krishna. So all the Atmas are coming from Him. They are tiny part and parcel of Bhagavan Krishna. Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, Mamaivangsa jiva loko jiva bhuta sanata. Eternally we are part and parcel of Bhagavan Krishna. Eternally I am not Chaitanya Chandra. Das can be eternally. I can become Das eternally, but I cannot become Chaitanya Chandra eternally. You cannot claim that you are Martin. Eternally you are Martin. No. Can? Cannot. But eternally you can say, I am the soul. I am the spirit soul. I am the part of the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna. We can claim that eternally. Boldly we can say. And therefore it is said, right ego. This is not false ego. This is right ego. I am Krishna's servitor. I am Krishna's part and parcel. This is right ego. You can say this very boldly. Then when we are saying that we are the part and parcel of Bhagavan Krishna, what Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna, then what is our duty? As a das, as a servitor, as a part, we'll have to cooperate, we'll have to serve, we'll have to help the Supreme One. This is our duty. But we are not doing that. We are not trying to give any pleasure to our Atma soul. Soul will become pleased, become blissful when soul will be engaged in Master Seva, Lord Seva. But we are not engaging our soul for that because we are illusioned. We are not thinking that we are spirit soul, we are thinking we are body. We are identifying with body. I am so and so. I took birth in this place. My name is so and so, my father is so and so. So, this what type of this relationship, what type of this identification is? Which is temporary, completely temporary. When the body is going, this type of identification will go, this type of connection will go, no relationship. Who was my father? When child will die, that Atma you will ask, I don't know who is my father. My father is only Krishna. The Supreme Lord is my father. That happened to the so many times you can see Srivas Pandit song. Then King Chitraketu's son died. They all said the same thing. We don't know who is our father. Father, only one father we have. He is Krishna. But we are having so much relationship, so much strong relationship, so much attachment. If Mahaprabhu, Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita is saying, Mahaprabhu saying that who is son, who is father, who is man, who is woman? No one is man here, no one is woman here. So she is saying to Sachimata, oh mother, you are thinking that I am your son, but I am nothing. Putra jnana. You are thinking that I am your putra, I am your son. The attachment you are having so much for me, if you develop that type of attachment towards Krishna, then your life will be successful. But you are not doing that. You are thinking, I am everything to you. Kinari ki purus aro keva karo pati Sri Krishna charana bino aro nai gati sei pita sei mata sei bandhu jana sei harta sei karta sei matra dhana putra snehe kara more jata bada bhavo Sri Krishna cha Rane haile kata hae labo Sei se parama bandho Sei pita mata Sri Krishna charane jai Prema bhakti dada Mahaprabhu saying, Kinari ki purush. What to speak about woman, man? Who is husband? Who is wife? So if you have no love for the lotus feet of Krishna, where is the gati? There is no other way left for us. He is your father, he is your mother, he is your friend. He is your maintainer, he is your protector. So he is your wealth. If you are developing so much affection for me, and you are thinking that is your only business or the great business, then I will say, you just develop that type of love affection unto Bhagavan Krishna. So then you will get so much benefit. And he is also saying that who is giving us the love of Krishna, he is also like our father, mother, friend. Amaro nistaro hoye toro paritrano Sri Krishna cha Ranabhaja Chhado Putra Gyano. If you will do Krishna bhajan, I will be delivered and you will also be delivered. So therefore, give up this relationship. I am your son and you are my mother. Just develop this relationship with Krishna. Accept Krishna as your mother, as your son. Become mother of Krishna. There is no problem. And he's saying, Ane ratanayo ane rajata suvarna khaile bi nasapai No he para dharma dhana uparjana kare ane bada dukha dhana ija ukakiva apani maruko So he's saying Aner tanayane rajat suvarna. Other sons, they are going to earn money and they are bringing so much gold and silver or money, wealth. But what they are bringing, actually they are not bringing sukha, happiness. In the name of wealth, name of money, they are bringing dukkha, this সাফারিংস। ধন উপার্জন করে আনে বড় দুঃখ, ধনই যাও কিংবা আপনি মরুক আমি আনি দে, ধনই যাও কিংবা আপনি মরুক। সো ওয়ান টাইম ওয়ে সপোজ ইউ লুজ এভরিথিং, নো ধন নো ওয়েলথ, ইউ পুট ইন দি ব্যাঙ্ক অ্যান্ড ব্যাঙ্ক হোয়াট ইজ দ্যাট, হ্যাঁ ব্যাঙ্ক্রাফ্ট অর দি ব্যাঙ্ক উইল বি ক্লোজড, হ্যাঁ ব্যাঙ্ক্রাফ্ট, ওকে ব্যাঙ্ক উইল বি ক্লোজড, দেন ইয়োর ব্যাঙ্ক মানি ইজ গন, সো নাও পিপুল আর পুটিং গোল্ড, হ্যাঁ দি ব্যাঙ্ক উইল বি ক্লোজড দে আর পুটিং গোল্ড, সপোজ গোল্ড উইল বি স্টোলেন হোয়াট উইল বি হ্যাপেন্ড, আই পুট অল মাই মানি অ্যান্ড পারচেসড গোল্ড, আই পুট গোল্ড, হোয়ার ইউ আর পুটিং গোল্ড, সেফ, ওয়েন ব্যাঙ্ক উইল বি ফিনিশ ইউ আর সেফ উইল বি। Some are in India, they are very clever. They don't put anything in bank because the bank, the income tax, they are always looking who is keeping money in the bank. Your Switzerland is a very safe place. Therefore, Indians are coming and putting money here. They cannot find how much money they are having. One time, one my colleague, somehow he heard that 100 rupees note will not be anymore, will not be accepted by bank. One type of 100 rupees note that time. They produced more, other design, other style. So this note will not be accepted anymore. So every day he was bringing 500, 600, every day he was changing in the bank. Because after some time, some time limit, that note cannot be accepted by anyone. We saw so much money he was keeping. That time when I am saying this thing, this is 1969, 70, 100 rupees note, very, very much. Anyone is having 100 rupees note means so much. Now even 1,000 rupees is no value. Every day he was changing. If that money will be stolen, what will be happened? You have kept in your own locker, own treasury, so it will be stolen. It will be burned. The house will be burned. The earthquake will come, everything finished. So what is the use of this? This type of wealth will not give us pleasure. Accumulating money. Therefore he is saying, Mahaprabhu, Ami ani debo hena, Ami ani debo Krishna, Prema hena dhano sakala sampadamaya, Krishnera charana সকল জন্মে পিতা মাতা সবাই পায় কৃষ্ণ গুরু নাই মিলে ভজ হইহায়। মহাপ্রভু সিং আমি আনি দিব কৃষ্ণ প্রেম হয় না দিব, আই উইল ব্রিং কৃষ্ণ প্রেম ধন, দি লভ ওয়েলথ, লভ ফর কৃষ্ণ, that I will bring for you. So that will never be lost. My love for Krishna, nobody will take away from me. I am Krishna Das, I am Krishna Servitor. Nobody will take away that position. But today I am President of Switzerland or Prime Minister of Switzerland, but tomorrow I may not be. But I am Das, Krishna Das. Nobody can take away. My love for Krishna, nobody can take away. So therefore he is saying, Ami ani devo Krishna prema hena dhanu. I will bring Krishna prem for you. Sakala sampad moy Krishner charana. Sakala sampad moy. All the wealth are there in Krishna's lotus feet. And everyone is getting father and mother. Everyone is having father and mother. Even the lower species also, father and mother are there. Sakal janme, every life will have father and mother. But who is actually giving us Krishna prem? Who is giving us love of Krishna? He is our real father. He is Guru, the spiritual master. The spiritual master is giving us Krishna, is giving us Krishna prem, love of Krishna. And that is the real wealth. If we are connected with Krishna and getting this wealth, then we are really happy, very blissful. We don't need this type of wealth, the material wealth. But those who are illusioned, they think this material wealth is everything for them. This material wealth can give us life. It will not give us life. When someone is dying, the material wealth cannot give life. So, there is no topic I can speak from the Shastra. It is said about Jagyavalka. Jagyavalka was said, one says Jagyavalka, he was having two wives. One is Maitreyi, another one is Katayani. These two wives. So Jagyavalka, he thought that he'll give up his family life, he'll go for sannyas. So therefore he called both the wives and he said that very soon I will give up my family life, I'll go to sannyas, go for sannyas. I have some property that I will divide between you equally. So Katayani didn't say anything. She said, okay, Prabhu, whatever your desire. But Maitreyi, she asked to her husband, Jagyavalka, you want to give us some property, some wealth or some property. Can you tell me that by getting that property, that wealth, I will become immortal? Amrita. No amrita, no death. Can I get it by your property? The Jagyavalka said no. By this property you cannot get any type of immortality, or I cannot say that you will not get death. So the thing is that you have asked a very good question. So please sit down with me. I will speak to you something. Then he started speaking that that okay, you cannot overcome death, but this property, this wealth will help you to get some material happiness. But Maitreyi was intelligent. She said, what I'll do with this material happiness? If I will get the death, so how this material wealth will help me? So therefore, what I'll do with this type of property? So, oh my dear husband, if you know something by which one can get immortality, please tell me that thing. Don't give me this type of allurement. Don't show me your property or wealth. Then Jagyavalka became happy. So he said, you are very dear to me. Earlier you were dear to me. And now I am going to renounce everything. Still you are dear to me. Because the way you asked question, that is really very nice question. Though I am going to renounce, but still I will say you are dear to me. He said that I will tell you about Atma Tattva. Atma. Atma. About soul. And you should listen very carefully this thing. He said, the wife is very dear to husband. Wife is dear to husband means that that wife is not actually seeing the happiness of husband. Rather, she is finding how she will become happy. But wife is very dear to husband. Similarly, the father is loving his son. When father is loving his son, he is not seeing the pleasure of son. He is seeing the pleasure of himself. Mother is putting the child into her lap and kissing. That time child is crying, but mother is still kissing. Because what mother is doing, that is for herself only, not for the child, not for the pleasure of child. Similarly, here said, many that like the wealth, many they like wealth, not for the pleasure of that wealth, for the pleasure of themselves. They like wealth. Brahmano, many they like Brahman. Brahmanas, they go and do some rituals for the welfare of family. So many they like Brahman. But why they like Brahmano? Because for their own pleasure, not for the pleasure of Brahman. So many, the king likes the citizens, but for not for the pleasure of citizens, but for his pleasure. Same thing, the citizens, they like the king for their own pleasure. If the government will not make any welfare for the citizens, citizens will change the government. Next time they will not get vote. So they will have to do something for the pleasure of citizens. So therefore, the bhakti, so-called bhakti, we are rendering bhakti to demigods. Not for the pleasure of demigods, but for our pleasure. So therefore, somebody is taking care of the cows, not for the pleasure of cows, for their own pleasure. They will get milk. So therefore, here it said that, O Maitri, what more I can say? So the people in general, they want their pleasure only. They don't see for the pleasure of anyone else. If the people will know about their soul, and they will know what the need of soul, then they can do something for the pleasure of Krishna. So, this Maitreya Muni said, when someone is doing for the pleasure of Krishna, then he is becoming so much happy. If you will see the pleasure there, Madan Mohan ji, Radha Madan Mohan ji is getting so much pleasure. So, and who is giving pleasure, he will see that, oh, so nice, beautiful. Radha Madan is beautiful. because he is giving so much pleasure to him, then automatically that pleasure will be reflected to the servitor one who is serving. We can take the example of Bhagavan Krishna and the gopis. The gopis, when they are going to Krishna, they are taking nice bath and nice cloth, decorating themselves, putting jewelries, putting perfume. So according to their ability, they try to decorate themselves very nicely and they are going to Krishna. When Krishna sees them, oh, gopis are so much nicely decorated themselves, so very beautiful. So when Krishna sees these gopis are very beautiful, then Krishna's pleasure increases. When Krishna's pleasure increases, then Krishna looks more handsome, more beautiful. And the gopis, they see, oh, Krishna is so beautiful today. Very beautiful, very beautiful. Then they become very happy. The gopis get so much happiness. When the gopis get so much happiness inside, their beauty increases. And Krishna sees, hey, gopis are again becoming so beautiful. Then Krishna becomes happy. So this way, the happiness always increases. Always increases. If one is going to serve Bhagavan Krishna and look for his happiness, that happiness will be reflected within himself. So how one can become happy? By serving this maya, illusory energy. That is for only, I am serving someone for my own pleasure. The husband serving also wife, wife serving husband for their own pleasure. They don't see pleasure of others. But if one is serving Krishna and getting so much pleasure, because Krishna is getting pleasure from him, then he becomes happy, then automatically we see that, oh, so happy. Krishna is so happy today. So how will lament? The lamentation will go. Here in this world, always lamentation is there, fear is there. And death is there. But there is no death, no fear, no lamentation. Asako abhayo amruto adhar tomar charana doyo tahate ekhono visramalabhya chadinu bhaver bhayo. That place, your lotus feet, the place at your lotus feet is fearless, deathless, fearless, and no lamentation. So now I took shelter at your lotus feet. So I gave up my all fear. And the same thing Bhagavan said in Bhagavad Gita, topmost confidential instruction, sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam saranam braja aham tvam sarva papebhyo mukhya sai ma suchu. Don't develop fear. Just surrender unto me. I will destroy your all sinful reactions. Then you will get happiness. We have committed some sinful activities. We are every day committing sinful activities. So how can we get happiness? Sense gratification is sinful activities. Everyone is engaged in their own sense gratifications. So how they will get happiness? Fear is there. Oh, my sense gratification will go. If I will join Krishna consciousness movement, I cannot drink alcohol. They are saying, no, no alcohol. So better I should not join. Why I'll go there? Unnecessary problem. Somebody said to me, mafia. Krishna consciousness is mafia. The devotees are just like mafia. If you'll go there, you cannot come out. Yes, we are mafia. You come, join. You'll get happiness here. That you'll not get there, outside. Fear is there. Fear is there to lose. I lose my money. I lose my position. I lose my relation. But here nothing loss. No loss is here. All gain are here. One will come to Krishna and he will say, I lost. That is never possible. Rather one is coming to Krishna and is gaining. So much gain. So, this is Maya. This is called illusion. We are thinking outside Krishna or without Krishna, we can enjoy. Yes, that's true. If you will forget Krishna, then you will go for enjoyment. As long as you are remembering Krishna, you cannot enjoy. You cannot go for enjoyment because in your mind Krishna is there. But the moment you will forget Krishna, that enjoyment will come. Or other words we can say, when we are enjoying, we are forgetting Krishna. And that is Maya, this is Krishna. So why you not come to Krishna? Get happiness forever. There is no bhaya. Krishna saying, no bhaya, ma sucha. Don't develop fear. Just come to me. I'll take care of everything. Yes. Gaurahari Prabhu would give all types of happiness if someone is coming to join this center. Yeah. He is ready to take care of everything. Just you join and you serve Krishna. You come and serve Krishna. Krishna will take care through Gaurahari Prabhu. Krishna will take care. He will not take care. His Shakti very limited. But by Krishna's mercy, by Guru's mercy, he can take care. So we should think very seriously, what is our duty? What is our duty? We should think, because our soul's duty, not our body duty. And we are not saying everyone should follow Gaurahari Prabhu. Gaurahari Prabhu renounced one. We are not saying that everyone should become brahmachari or sannyasi or vanaprasthi. You can become grihastha also. You can have your family life also. But one thing you can do, put Krishna in the middle. Make the Krishna samsara, Krishna family. This family is Krishna family. The children, they belong to Krishna. I belong to Krishna, my wife belongs to Krishna, so my children also belong to Krishna. So Krishna is taking care of everything. Ebe atma samarpana chinta nahi ar. Tumi nirbhaye prabhu, sansar tumar. Now I surrender to you, then my responsibility ceases. No more I am responsible. It is your sansar, it is your family, you will take care. You will maintain the family. How my son will get education? How my daughter will get married? How my livelihood go on? All these things is up to you. I don't know anything. I just want to come and serve Krishna. I just want to come and listen about Krishna Katha. I just want to come and chant Hare Krishna. And that is the Yuga Dharma. I cannot do anything else. I'm busy. I cannot. Someone say, oh, I'm busy. What can I do? You tell me very brief. Oh, you should not do anything. Just chant Hare Krishna. This Sunday, Prabhuji making program, everybody can come, chant and listen, then they can understand how they are connected with Krishna. So this much, we don't want anything. Grihe thako, bane thako, sada hari bale dako. You may remain your griha or your samsar. Or you can come as vanaprastha brahmachari sannyasi. You wander in the forest. But what is the problem? To chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. The easiest way given in this age of Kali. Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he brought this name for us. This name was there in Shastra, scripture. This is not new, but Mahaprabhu brought it for connecting us with Krishna, with love. How much love is there? If chanting, one is chanting Krishna Nam, Harinam, he can develop loving relationship with Bhagavan Krishna very easily. For which Mahaprabhu is saying, I brought this Krishna Prem Dhanu. I can bring this Krishna Prem Dhanu to you. So who are following Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu's dear devotees, they can get Krishna, Nam Krishna Prem, and they can connect themselves with Krishna Bhagavan nicely. So everything will be taken care by Bhagavan Krishna. You have no time, 3:05, so we'll keep it here. Harinam Sankirtan ki jai. Jai Shri Radha Madan Mohan Jiu ki jai. Shri Shri Gaur Nitai ki jai. Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj ki jai. Samabet Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari. Jai Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj ki jai. Any short question, anything?
How do I know what would make Krishna more happy? To live as Grihastha or to join Pentagon and be
whatever ashram you are in, no problem. Mahaprabhu's associates, 3.5 associates, very close associates, out of them, 2.5 Grihastha. Only one was sannyasi. So there is no question. You can remain Grihastha, you can remain Brahmachari, you can remain Sannyasi or Vanaprastha, no question. But in your heart you develop love for him. You serve him with love. And in order to get this love, in order to know how to serve him so that he will be pleased, his own man will tell you. Nija Jana, own man. His own man, or we can say his own bhakta. They can tell you how you can please him so that you will get pleasure also. The loving relationship will be developed. Okay? Activities.
Activities lunch, and then I have to take the food what my sister is cooking for my mother, and according to Krishna conscious rules, you shouldn't.
Your mother.
My mother, my sister.
Your mother, sister. They are pushing you to take lunch with them.
Yes, my sister.
Why not you will invite them to here? Take lunch here with you. They are asking you to take lunch with them. Why not you ask them to come and take lunch here with you? Okay, you bring more and more. So when they will take prasad, They will not take on any nonsense. So they will cook prasad for you also.
Huh?
If they are cooking, tell them, if you are cooking, cook with nice consciousness, because Supreme Lord is taking your cooking. It will be offered to the Supreme Lord. So please do in nice consciousness, nice heart. Then he will take, then we can all take his remnants. Mercy. Okay? Yeah. Thank you very much.
Babuji will be here also tomorrow morning, tomorrow evening, and Tuesday morning, giving lecture. Now we are a little bit short of time because families and children are there and we have to go with the Sunday feast. But the next days the lecture will be, we can go really long with questions also and more discussions.
Yeah.
Thank you all for coming. Thank you, Chaitanya Chandra.
Thank you for arranging everything.